I mean, either it's accurate or it's not accurate. I mean, are they saying, well, we put this use-by test on there for your safety, but actually we're going to take it off because it's sort of made up?
Well, have you ever smelt off milk?
No, you see, I have a problem. Did I not tell you my story about me working on the milk float?
Here we go. You did mention you'd worked
yes.
on it, yeah?
And curdled milk.
Oh.
And I have... I'm not big into milk.
All right. I love milk, but I have smelt sour milk and it's a no-go. But I think milk lasts a really long time now.
I wouldn't risk it.
We quite often buy the big, you know, the big bottles yeah. and I'm surprised at how long it lasts.
But if they take that tab off and now you don't know how long it lasts... I mean, I suppose it is back to the old days. We just look at it and are there bits floating in it and then you realise it's curdled?
Yeah.
Or would you actually smell it? And
well, yeah, sometimes you do have to do a sniff test, don't you? But the thing is, milk's changed now. It's not like it was when we were growing up, or at least maybe I don't buy full-fat milk anymore. But when I was growing up, we had the full-fat with the cream on the top.
Yes.
And then you would get the floating bits.
Yes.
Oh, this is really...
But not
lots of people will be pouring their milk onto their cereal, watching us as we speak. Are you having a sniff? How would you feel about having to sniff your cereal? It's a bit cheesy.
But in short, I don't believe big business does it for our benefit. Big business does things for its own benefit. So why are they doing this?
Mm.
Are they caring about the environment, about the world, about
money saving, isn't it?
It's always something to do with money, and we're the victims of it.